What good is the symbol of me in this office? The work that I do doesn't make a difference in the lives of the young boys in Park Hill.
Denver Mayor Michael B. Hancock and the Office of Children's Affairs met with educators, nonprofits, law enforcement, and community members at the Community College of Denver to map out a strategy for engaging at-risk minority males in positive endeavors after accepting President Obama's challenge to participate in the My Brother's Keeper initiative. The initiative, launched in February 2014, is aimed at improving the futures of young minorities, specifically males.
Very powerfully, as one of the speakers said, I know you. As we talk about these young men who are finding themselves at risk, who are finding themselves embroiled in hopelessness at times, seem powerless, we know them because they are us and we have been them. And so the fact that, you know, we have the bully pulpit and the opportunity to come in, to not speak to them, but to speak with them and to sit with them and try to understand, that's a powerful opportunity. And then I'm also a father. I'm a father of a 19-year-old young man who is facing many of the same challenges. I got nephews who are his age or a little older who are dealing with the same issues. So this is very personal. This is not something I'm reading about. I'm in this game. I'm in this battle every day with the young men who are in my life.
Many presenters at the event have both professional and personal interests in seeing disenfranchised young men of color reconnected with their communities.
I have two older sons. One is what we would say on the on-time college track, and one that is working and going to school, great kid, but he had to figure out his own way.
Low reading scores and high dropout rates are persistent in majority minority communities like Montbello, Villa Park, and Northeast Park Hill. Although strides have been made in the at-risk youth population, the lack of basic skills and education credentials lead to fewer employment opportunities for young adults.
Of African-American boys and 59% of Latino boys are graduating. What about that other, 40%? That is huge. And so we're not doing enough.
The consequences of not properly educating our young people are enormous. It costs a heck of a lot less to prepare them to compete in this global economy than to have to go back and repair them or deal with the consequences of them not being educated properly. The cost of incarcerating a kid is almost three times the cost of educating them. And so the reality is that we must pay and sacrifice today to make sure that all of our kids are properly educated, properly equipped to go and compete, so they can be more productive in society and not dependent on society, and many times ultimately incarcerated by society. We can do much better than that. We will do much better than that.
Ideas generated at the My Brother's Keeper Summit will help communities to do more.
We can all get up and give beautiful speeches and talk about the power of this challenge we're facing, but now it's time to go to work. And with what's going on today in the breakout sessions, that people are digging in and they're talking about the things of workforce development, social and emotional health, juvenile justice and education. And they're going to create measurable strategies so that we can keep coming back and measuring how we're doing, evaluating.
Young men of color are also a key component in making the initiative successful.
So I'm black and proud.
Peter Lubambela, the son of Tanzanian refugees, is finding friends.
Throughout the mistakes I learned and just finding the Boys and Girls Club and being embraced who I am, they held me accountable.
The reason why I'm here today among you beautiful people is because I want to be the change I wish to see in my community.
For high school junior Robert Baskerville, getting involved with the My Brother's Keeper initiative is about saving lives after almost losing his own.
I got shot by elementary school, so what if there had been little kids around? The bullet was a centimeter away from killing me. It's my mistake, and I want other people to learn from it. It shouldn't take a life-changing experience for you to get good grades and for you to listen to your parents. It should automatically be like that. And for some kids, it's not. It wasn't like that for me, so I like to just spread my word.
Partnerships between communities and nonprofit organizations born out of the My Brother's Keeper initiative will allow Robert and so many students like him to do just that.
How many of you feel optimistic and confident about the productivity today and the direction that we're headed? Good. Now we have to have the hard conversations and hold ourselves accountable for doing the right work the right way. And that means our ideas need to be tested. We need to say why these strategies and these goals are going to get the job done. Why they're going to have the best, the most impact on our young people. What is the evidence that we have that it's going to work? So we're going to be testing our ideas. So we're going to get down into some really hard work. So we need you to be thinking about other people that you have in mind that need to be a part of your work groups to begin answering those difficult questions. So the last thing I'll do, and then we'll say goodbye and thank you very much, is stand up and to the person next to you, somewhere next to you, a high five or a big hug, and tell them you expect and you look forward to seeing them at our next session. Have a great day.